Hello friends, welcome to my channel English with Chagan Arora. Friends, today we are going to discuss Abhigyan Shakuntalam by Kalidas. This work is from Kalidas, The Loom of Time, and this work is actually written in Sanskrit and Maharashtri Prakrit, but it is translated in English by Chandra Rajan. The proper name famously known as this work as The Recognition of Shakuntala Through a Token. This was the first ever translation made of an Indian play into Western language. Even in 1789, William Jones first translated this work into English. This work is not completely entirely composed in Sanskrit, and it contains some elements of a Middle English dialect known as Maharashtri Prakrit. So let us start the play. About the play, the roots of this play are taken from epic Mahabharat, and several changes are made to derive dramatic effect, and all they worked. As a result, most people consider the version of The Origin of Bharat, Misfortune of Shakuntala, and Story of Dushyant by Kalidas in Abhigyan Shakuntalam is authentic. The play revolves around Shakuntala, who is the daughter of great Rishi Vishwamitra and heavenly damsel Menaka. Vishwamitra, in order to gain great rewards, gets into deep meditation, and Lord of Heaven Indra gets worried about his predicament if the saint completes his meditation. To save his position and to worship as one with no equal, Indra sent Menaka to lure Vishwamitra out of his contemplation of God. After many efforts, Menaka successfully disturbed the firm mind of saint, and he falls in love with the beauty of damsel. As a result, Shakuntala, this name was given by Karnav Rishi. Karnav is born, and Vishwamitra finally realizes that he has lost due to union and reject the Menaka and Shakuntala. Menaka is forbidden to enter heaven with a human child, so she leaves her daughter in a forest, knowingly very well that the forest is under the protection of Karnav Rishi. So he will take care of her. As expected by Menaka, Karnav find the baby girl surrounded by the birds called Shakuntala. Thus he names her Shakuntala, as she was seen with birds, who seems to enjoy playing with her. When the play Abhigyan Shakuntalam opens, Shakuntala is seen in her youth with graceful mind and body. And now we will start the story of Abhigyan Shakuntalam, first in prologue. The play opened with a benediction to gods, and after the benediction, the director and actress are entered on the stage. The director introduced the name of the play, Abhigyan Shakuntalam, and asked to treat the audience with a song about season summer. She sings so well that director is spellbound and forgets why he is on the stage, until she reminds the purpose of their appearance. The prologue ends with director mentioning about failing of memory and relate it to hunting Dushyant. Act first, or the chase. This scene is in forest, and then the hermitage of Karnav Rishi. Dushyant, who is the king of Hastinapur, tries to capture a deer and seen on his chariot, when a hermit intervenes and warns that this place is under the protection of a hermitage, and any animal that enters the place shall not be harmed. The king honors the word of hermitage and withdraw his arrows and put it back in his quiver. The hermit blessed the king with a boon to have a noble son and asked him to visit the hermitage of Karnav Rishi. Dushyant is knowledgeable enough to know that a hermit should be entered with all the modesty. Therefore, he asked the charioteer to halt, remove all his jewels and kingly costumes to appear like a normal individual. As he steps towards, he hears the sound of hermit's skull and is taken away by the beauty of them. So he decides to hide behind a tree and observe them. Shakuntala, her friend Prembada and Anusuya Shakuntala, her friend Priyamvada and Anusuya, they are conversing with each other while a bee troubles Shakuntala and admiring Dushyant is come out from hiding to save her from the forcing theft. At first, Shakuntala gets scared of seeing a man who doesn't belong to hermitage and runs away. Dushyant reveals his true identity and is graciously invited to hermitage. Shakuntala falls in love with the king as his delightful words and his face attract her very much. Dushyant gave his ring to Shakuntala as a token. The king leaves the serene hermitage as the soldiers approach with loud shouts. Act 2, concealment of telling. This act is also happened in forest. Act Madhav. Madhav is court jester of Hastinapur and a close companion of Dushyant, it seems, complaining about his ill fate, having to wander the forest and eat on everything he could get instead of rejoicing in the palace. He tries to show his frustration when the king meets him. However, Dushyant console him and make him agree to help. They conspire together so that Dushyant can get as close as possible to beautiful Shakuntala. Dushyant is reminded of the fast done by his mother and the oath Dushyant took to participate on the last day. At first, at this crossroads, unable to decide whether to fulfill the oath or carry on with his heart surrendering, Dushyant sent Madhav to the king's palace as his younger brother, so that he could get closer to Shakuntala. Act 3, love's quotation. This scene is also in the hermitage of Kannavarishi. The king could not resist himself from returning to the hermitage to see Shakuntala, and as he enters, speaking the charm of Shakuntala possesses, she and her friends enter, talking in a flirtatious manner. He hides and watches them as they speak in that manner, and Shakuntala begins to sing of love. Dushyant comes out of hiding, unable to subdue his heart's craving due to influence of the poem. The four of them talk, and gradually Priyamvada and Anusuya slip away, leaving the pair of Shakuntala and Dushyant in a solitary independence. As their heart dazzles with thoughts of lovers' flirtation, and they get closer to each other conversation, from a distance, the voice of Gautami, who is wife of Kannavarishi, is heard calling for Shakuntala. The pair separated with regret, and Shakuntala links with Gautami, whereas Dushyant leaves to help the ascetics complete the evening prayers. Act 4. Act 4 is the most important act in this play. Its name is Departure of Shakuntala, and this scene is also in the hermitage of Kannavarishi. From the conversation of Anusuya and Priyamvada, it is revealed that Dushyant and Shakuntala are married, and they talk of the king returning to his capital, Praxiti, over fulfilling his desire to marry Shakuntala. Kannav's reaction to the union attacks her. However, they conclude that everything will go just right as they hear a voice announcing himself at the hermitage while they are picking flowers. Knowing of uncertain state of Shakuntala, who is now always thinking of Dushyant, hurry back to see if she has properly received the guest. The guest is Durvasa Rishi, a great saint with intense hunger. Durvasa Rishi is famous for his intense rage. He becomes frustrated to see Shakuntala not receiving him properly, and he curses her like this: "You who don't notice me, a heart of holy Mary standing at your door, because you are lost in thought of one to exclusion of all else. You shall be lost in his thoughts. Though you good his memory hard, he will fail to remember you, even as a man drunk remembers not thereafter the tale he told before." This is the curse of Durvasa Rishi. As Durvasa is very powerful, so there is nothing they can do about the curse. Instead, they plead for consolation. Durvasa says that the token of the king, which was the ring, would enable king to remember who Shakuntala is, and all the lost memories will be restored. This scene shifts And Shakuntala is showing prepare herself to leave to royal palace with the hope to restore the memory of her husband and make him aware of her pregnancy. Gautami helps her, so do Anusuya and Priyambada. Meanwhile, Kanav Rishi enters after completing his prayer with grief, stricken heart as his daughter leaving. Gautami, Saradvata and Sarangra are also ordered to go with Shakuntala and ensure she reached the palace safely and reunion is without any trouble. Emotion flow through Kanav Rishi and every other individual in her hermitage as she leaves. This act in Abhigyan Shakuntalam contains most unexpected events, from announcing of marriage to curse and acceptance of marriage by Kanav and Gautami. Act 4. The repudiation of Shakuntala. This scene is in the palace of Hastinapur. The king is seen with his busy schedule and is weary by performing his duties. Madhav asks to listen the song and music played by her wife Hamsavati. The song suggests subtly that she is being neglected, and Dushyant feels a yearning in his heart that he can't understand the reason for his heart to behave so as such. In this moment, the guard announces the presence of hermitage from the hermit of Kanav, and Dushyant asks for them immediately by inviting them with proper rites. After the repetition, Sarang and Gautami reminds the king of the secret marriage between him and Shakuntala. But Dushyant can't remember anything. Shakuntala, understanding the effects of curse by Durvasa Rishi, tries to produce the ring on her hand, and to her surprise, the ring won't be in its place. Shakuntala, shattered by the absence of ring, stands in palace without any proof, while Gautami exclaims that the ring might have slipped off in the pool while she was washing her face. Dushyant accuses the hermits and Shakuntala, but the high priest suggests seeing if there is any truth behind the story, as the people are from the hermitage of Kanav Rishi. Dushyant agrees to provide facilities in palace till the child is born, so that the child would be examined and determined which of two parties is speaking the truth. However, heartbroken Shakuntala asks the earth to take her, and she is taken away by life to the bewilderment of Dushyant. Act 6. The separation from Shakuntala. This scene is in capital of Dushyant and the pleasure garden. Two guards recognize the royal signet ring in possession of a fisherman. The fisherman pleads that he found the ring in a fish he caught lately. A police chief goes to the king and submits the ring, which disturbs him a lot. The fisherman is given leave without any punishment and further given compensation. However, Dushyant feels horribly sorry for himself and the way he treated Shakuntala. By that time, recognition of Shakuntala means Abhijan Shakuntalam through a token by is fulfilled. He has absolutely no idea where she was and how to find her. Miss Rekshi, an apsara and damsel, came to check the situation in the palace as it was requested by Menaka, and she oversees things invisibly. She finds out from maids that king is in a miserable condition, and she relates the same predicament to Shakuntala. Dushyant expresses his grief to Madhav, and the court jester tries to console him. Meanwhile, Chatrika, another maid, brings the portrait of Shakuntala, which intensifies the grief of King Dushyant, and same he feels terrible loneliness without his love. As the queen Vasumati is expected to make her presence in garden, Dushyant hand over the painting of Shakuntala to him and asks to flee. An attendant comes to Dushyant and informs that queen has returned, observing a note in his hand. The note is about a wealthy merchant who unfortunately died in a shipwreck and all his property is unclaimed. The king orders to give the property to whichever wife is pregnant, but decide against it, as it is only fair to do justice to everyone. depending on the trade of merchant. So he orders to share all the properties of merchant to his family and loved ones. The thought of a pregnant wife disturbs Dushyant, as with blindness turned out the one who was about to produce the heir of his family and the future king of Hastinapur. As he laments his decision, he hears cries of anguish and finds Madhav is taken by a demon form. He chases the demon and frees his friend, and only to find that the demon is Matali, who came to take Dushyant to assist in battle against demon Kalnemi. It is revealed that Madali intentionally apprehended Madhav to distract the king from the misery. Both Madali and Dushyant mount the chariot as the act ends. And now, Act 7, Shakuntala's prosperity. This scene is in celestial region and hermitage of Marichrishi. Dushyant, along with other warriors of heaven, won all the demons, and he is seen returning with Madali. As they travel through the path of heaven, Dushyant expresses desire to pay homage to hermitage of Matali Rishi, Marich Rishi. Matali take him to hermitage and leave the king in that palace. As the king contemplate on divine presence and tranquility in the hermitage, he hears some voice and turn towards them to find a young boy playing with loin cup, trying to open its mouth so that he could count the number of teeth. He feels so related to the boy that he goes and pampers him, and aesthetics are surprised to see that the boy also feels comfortable with the stranger. The aesthetic women realize the armlet of boy is missing, and Dushyant finds it where the boy was wrestling the loin club previously. Marich gives that armlet during the natal rites of the child, and it is a charmed armlet. Anyone apart from the parents or the boy himself touches the armlet, it turns into snake and bites them. The aesthetic immediately recognize the stranger as Dushyant, and the king is joyously confident that the boy is his own, and Shakuntala is in the hermitage of Marich Rishi. Shakuntala and Dushyant unite in tears, and king explains how his memory got restored once he saw the ring found by a fisherman. Marich, Aditi and Matali enter the scene, and Marich bless the pair to live in prosperity. Marich states that their family needs no boon, as it includes a father equal to Indra and a mother born of a damsel and son who can make diamonds run. The play Abhijan Shakuntalam ends with the blissful reunion, and the family is seen to return to palace of Dushyant. This version of Abhijan Shakuntalam by Kalidas is different from the one mentioned in epic Mahabharata. However, apart from dramatic effects and dialogue, the story reached to its end in the same way as that described in the epic Mahabharata. Thank you very much, friends. Wish you a best of luck for your future exam. Thank you very much. Have a good day.